Thank you, Rim. Good afternoon, friends. Welcome to the Q3FY18 earnings call of the Rane Group. To take you through the results and answer your questions today, we have the management team from the Rane Group, Mr. L. Ganesh, Chairman and Managing Director, Rane Holdings Limited, Mr. Harish Lakshman, Vice Chairman, Rane Holdings Limited, Mr. Shiva Chandrasekharan, Executive Vice President of the Secretary of Legal Services, and Mr. J. Anand, CFO of Rane Holdings Limited. Please note that we have sent you the press release and also the presentation link of the deck that Harish would go through today. In case any of you have not received the presentation, you could look at it on our website or even the BSE website where it's been uploaded. Before we start, I would like to say that everything that is said on this call that reflects any outlook for the future or which can be construed as a forward-looking statement must be viewed in conjunction with the risks and uncertainties that we face. These uncertainties and risks are included but not limited to what we mentioned in the prospectus and subsequently the annual reports which you can find on our website. With that said, I will now hand over the call to Mr. Ganesh. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Divakar. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for dialing in and welcome to this conference call. You would have seen the quarter 3 FY18 performance highlights of the group, which have been posted on our website. I would just like to add a few comments and then hand it over to Harish. This quarter has been a good quarter for the group. All the companies have done better. This was enabled by a favorable demand environment. The Indian auto industry had a strong growth across all vehicle segments. Passenger vehicles grew, supported by the utility vehicle segment. Medium and heavy commercial vehicles had a good growth on the back of a pickup in infrastructure activity and mining activities. Turning to the group performance, Rane Group sales registered a good, healthy growth of 30% during this quarter. The EBITDA at the group level improved from 10.6 to 13%. This was mainly due to operational leverage and cost reduction initiatives across the various companies. The aggregate PBT, without exceptional items, grew from a margin of about 4.8 to about 8.2%. Rane Madras sales grew by 32%. We had a strong demand from Indian OE customers and higher offtake from the Indian aftermarket. Increased volume, favorable product mix, and improved operational performance helped post strong margin improvement in Rane Madras. At Rane Engine Valves, we had a good demand from Indian OE customers and international customers. However, the plants are still struggling with some delivery issues and higher rejections, although we could see some improvement in capacity realization and operational performance. There's still a long way to go at Rane Engine Valves. Rane Brake Linings net sales grew by 12%. We saw a demand recovery in the aftermarket segment. Favorable commodity, foreign exchange movement, and higher cost savings helped improve the margins. Rane TRW and Rane NSK continue to have a very good quarter on their product segments, all their segments, and served models to deliver a very strong revenue and profit growth. We expect the favorable demand environment to continue in quarter four. With these opening remarks, I now hand it over to Harish for his comments, after which we'll be happy to take any questions that you might have. Thank you.
So good afternoon, everyone. Just a few comments from my side, basically focusing on the sales performance of the industry and the group. So the revenue, obviously, the overall group growth has been quite good this quarter. The revenue from Indian OE customers grew by almost 34%. This was achieved as we had a very favorable performance compared to the industry across major segments, especially passenger vehicle and commercial vehicle. In passenger vehicle, the growth was supported by supplies to new business, and in M&SCV segment, we had increased share of business with certain select customers for steering products that helped post a better performance. In farm sector, even though we had a positive growth, we did not grow in line with the market because we were actually affected by delivery bottlenecks on the engine valve side, and also in steering products for the tractor segment. The power steering segment of the farm tractor has been growing faster. Although we have improved our performance vis-a-vis last year, the market still outgrew us. In two-wheeler, again, favorable performance was supported by better growth for dispatch products. From an international customer standpoint, again, we had an 18% growth, mainly driven by the occupant safety products from Rane TRW. The aftermarket segment has also significantly picked up post-GST impact. So from October onwards, we've seen continuous improvement, and actually on a quarter-to-quarter basis, we've had a 25% growth. So with these four few words, I'd like to open the floor for any questions. Thank you.
Sure, thank you very much. We will now begin with the question and answer session. Participants who wish to ask questions may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking questions. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. We have the first question from the line of Viraj V from Securities Investment Management. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity and congratulations on a good set of numbers. Hello?
Yes. Go ahead.
Just had a couple of questions. First is on the Rane TRW. Just want to get some idea, to which customers in steering have we seen increase market share, and what would be our current wallet share to these customers? And if you can give the split between steering and occupant safety in Q3 and comparable figure last year.
As far as steering, the growth is across all customers. Basically, there are only five or six commercial vehicle players in the country, which is Tata, Ashok Leyland, Volvo, Eicher, Mahindra, Truck and Bus, and Daimler being the major ones. And then there are a couple of smaller ones. We supply to all of them. So to answer your question, the growth has been across all customers. Basically, the split in Q3 between SG and
Q3 45.
Yeah. So the steering was 55% of RTS's sales in Q3. And the occupant safety was 45.
Okay, and comparable figure last year?
I think it was 60.
Just hold on.
Yeah. 60-40.
Okay. Second question is, in TRW, again, we've taken some capacity increase. And considering the growth profile we're seeing both on steering and occupant safety, if you can just outline, what are the capex plans for FY19, FY20 for this business, and how are we looking to fund it?
So we still don't have a clear plan as yet on capex. We're still working out. As you know, the new financial starts in April, but I can tell you this, that definitely we will be enhancing capacity. As you know, the steering side, the fortunes of the business are driven by the commercial vehicle, and clearly we are seeing a revival in the market, and we believe this growth will continue into next year. So as a result, we will be enhancing capacities. And occupant safety, as mentioned in several earlier calls, the growth of our seatbelt and airbag business, is the order book looks good for the next 2 years. And we have also put it out in the investor presentation, we are in the process of building a second plant for the occupant safety systems business. So,
okay. And would the current in Q3 revenue would also include sales to Renault, or that is yet to reflect in coming orders?
Sales to Renault.
For airbags.
Yeah, that is not resumed.
Okay. Last question was on the, margins. So if you look at the current margin profile which we have in TRW, now typically what do you understand, the part of the occupant safety, where we do primarily assembly operations for airbags, that typically earns between 8 to 10% EBITDA margin. Now, if you look at the overall consolidated basis also, you know, we've seen a significant margin expansion for TRW. So just want to understand, you know, where we're seeing that margin expansion.
Yeah, I mean, the steering M&HCV business growth is definitely helping the margin improvement. You know, obviously, there's better absorption of fixed costs. But of course, I must say that even on the occupant safety system side, the margin has improved vis-a-vis last year. It may not be as high as steering, but there is improvement on that as well. So both are contributing.
Okay, so is this a sustainable margin one should be looking at in this business? I mean, considering the kind of
outlook
we share right now.
See, dollar is a function of the market. If you tell me the commercial vehicle market will continue to grow at 15% every quarter, you know, then the confidence in maintaining these margins is high.
Got it. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Manish Goyal from Inam Holding. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. Congratulations on excellent numbers, sir. Sir, continuing on Rane TRW, if you can give us a breakup of revenue between seat belts and airbags, and as well as domestic and exports for safety occupant, please, in quarter three. Seat belts and airbags and domestic and exports.
In OSS, total turnover for quarter 3 is 130 crores, of which export is close to 38%.
Okay, and would it be possible to give a breakup of say seat belts and airbags?
Seat belt will be 75%,
airbag will be 25%. Seat belt is 75% and airbags is
25%. Okay. This is on the quantity in terms of numbers, value it is 60-40.
Ignore the 75, that was based on quantity.
Okay, 60% and 40% seat belts and airbags. Okay. And even the export number what you gave was the value, right?
Yes.
Okay. And sir, on margins, sir, now, like we have seen across the group companies, the margins have seen a decent improvement on operating leverage and favorable product mix. So now with commodity prices going up, are we in a position to kind of pass on the cost increase with a, say, lag of one or two quarters?
So, good question. So, yes, clearly the prices are going up and it's a matter of concern, and I think it is inevitable, especially starting from the April quarter onwards. So the objective is to, you know, get these price increases from the customers.
Sure.
Because these are all genuine, valid increases. But as you know, in our industry, it's never that straightforward. It's always a battle to get these increases from customers, but we intend to do it.
Okay. And in particularly for Rane Madras, the margins what we see at roughly EBITDA margin of nearly 12%. So that is sustainable, sir?
Again, same question, same response, Manish. I mean, if this M&HCV, farm tractor, you know, all this continue to grow in the same strong manner, maintaining this margin is a possibility.
Product mix has been very favorable,
sure,
as we had mentioned.
Right.
So that has helped in the margins.
Right, sir. And on precision die casting, sir, how is it progressing, sir, the U.S. subsidiary?
So the U.S. subsidiary, you know, by and large, as I mentioned earlier, we had given ourselves 3 years for break-even. Till Q2, everything was going according to plan. There has been some slight, you know, dip in demand in what I call Q3 for us, but the October, November, December for the U.S. market,
right?
Because of some product mix issues, etc. So that is impacting a little bit. But by and large, you know, there's nothing major to this thing report.
And last question on Rane NSK, sir. One is if you can give some insight on outlook, number one. And number two, the presentation mentions that margins were better because of one-off price settlement. So was it significant, or if you can please clarify that?
I think the one-off price settlement was an old issue. Some issues were pending with the customer, so that effect has come in the quarter. I don't think it's so significant, but it is over a period of time which has come in one quarter. That is the reason we mentioned. Now, is it sustainable? The demand seems to be sustainable, as you know, Maruti being our main customer, and the models which we are catering are doing very well. And with their production increase in Gujarat, also from the new plant, the call-offs are good. Indications for 18-19 also are good. So I think this kind of performance is sustainable, at least for the next 1 or 2 years.
Okay, so we are part of the new programs which Maruti is probably launching, sir.
Yes. I mean, as you know, we keep winning some of the new programs, but as of now, we are in all the good selling models, so that has given us the benefit.
Sure, sure. Thank you. And last question on Rane Brake. The OE sales seems to be muted, sir. So you did mention in Q2 that there are some reasons which probably are we can't probably fathom it. So any sense, sir, on why OE sales have been muted for Rane Brake? And related question, that 19%+ margin for Rane Brake, how do we see it going?
See, in terms of OE pairs, the sales was muted. Now, we tried to understand whether it's also a GST effect. Their customers were also trying to figure out the GST effect, but that seems to be now on a recovery path. As Arish mentioned, both aftermarket, OES, everything has recovered now. GST seems to be behind us. So that was the reason. In terms of margin, we see commodity prices hardening in Rane Brake Linings also. So there is a cause for concern. And here, it is not a one-to-one passing on to customers always, because there are some formulations, there are some indirect materials, which sometimes we are not able to pass on to the customer. So there is some cause for concern. We are watching the situation closely on commodity prices.
Thank you. Before we take the next question, we'd like to inform participants that in order to ensure that the management is able to address questions from all participants in the conference, please limit your questions to two per participant. The next question is from the line of Sanjay Shah from KSA Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good afternoon and congratulations, sir. Sir, just to, I would like your help to figure out my, tally my figures regarding our consolidated numbers. We are taking into account in Rane Holding, we are taking Rane Madras and Rane TRW as a revenue total. Am I right, sir?
And Rane Brake.
And Rane?
Rane Madras, Rane Engine and Rane
Brake. Rane Engine, yeah. So while I was combining these three, I was not able to get the total of the figure what it's been given in presentation.
This also includes our overseas subsidiary also, Rane Madras consolidated and Rane Engine and Rane Brake. And the telematic subsidiary is a small number.
Telematic subsidiary and Rane Madras US subsidiary.
Yes.
Okay. Sir, I'll come back to you later on offline to understand that math actually.
Sure.
And sir, can you get me the how do you see the future of this Rane Valve? Since we are struggling, we have been working hard on that, which I understood. But how do you see the how it's pan going ahead, sir?
No, so, you know, obviously it has taken a lot longer than we had anticipated. And I would say that there is improvement, but we still have a long way to go, I think, as Mr. Ganesh mentioned. So, I mean, the EBITDA continues to be profitable, but obviously we want to, you know, start generating profits at a PBT level. So there are action plans underway. The growth in the market is also helping us. but the operational issues that we are dealing with will take at least another 6 to 9 months, for us to achieve full, get back to a certain level of performance.
Right, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thanks for replying.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Karan Rathod from Akash Ganga Investment.
Hi, sir.
Yeah.
My question is relating to Rane Madras Limited. In the Indian die casting division, any new orders which we have received?
Nothing major to report at this stage. There are some small incremental businesses, but no significant thing to report.
And so my second question is related to the next year two orders, of which one got cancelled. Have we started delivering on the other order?
So there were actually three orders. One, we have started delivering and regular supplies are going on. That was a smaller order. The second one, that was a big one, that obviously got cancelled. The third one, we are waiting to hear from the customer. But all the programs, both those programs, as we have said earlier, got impacted because of that the Peugeot Opel transaction.
Okay, and the order for which we are currently delivering, the value of the order would be?
We'll have to get back. I'm not able to recollect from the top of our head. It's not a very big number.
By what time we should hear about the third order?
We don't know as yet. Really, we keep hearing from them that, the transaction has been completed. There are a lot of complexities, between GM and Peugeot. I think they're still working through all the details. So we also keep anxiously following it with them. We don't get a clear timeline.
Any other export orders we have currently in Rane Madras?
Continuously we work on export orders. We get some new orders, off-highway vehicles, some existing customers, linkages. We are continuously working. So, although there is nothing significant to report as one big order, we continuously work on export orders and order books are quite healthy.
And the last question would be on Q3 has been pretty good for Rane Madras. So, going forward, can we expect the same performance?
Yeah, as I said, the market product mix has been favorable, medium and heavy commercial and tractors and passenger cars, all the three where we are strong have done well. So with the same kind of market growth, Rane Madras 18-19 also should look quite positive.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Payal M. from WOW Investments. Please go ahead.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening.
Congratulations for the robust numbers. Sir, my question to you is about the Rani Precision subsidiary thing. And another question is, how much is the die casting market in India and international? Whether the same RNL will be in the same position to be at a break-even as earlier years on a standalone basis or what? And is the top line and bottom line sustainable?
Your first question was, can you repeat your first question on Rane Precision? It was not clear.
Yeah, I wanted to know about its operational status, about the international order and the domestic order front.
No, so the Rane Precision is entirely for the U.S. market.
It is a very
small export, but it is insignificant.
Right.
98% is for the domestic market. So it is driven by the fortunes of the North American passenger car market.
Okay.
And as I said, that business will take some more time for a turnaround, which was the, we had obviously purchased a distressed asset and we had given ourselves 3 years to to make the, to turn around the business. So that is by and large going according to plan. As far as the Indian die casting business is concerned, almost 75% is exports. About 25% is domestic. And
right.
Your third question, the RML standalone is profitable, already is profitable, and this year, thanks to the steering division performance, the overall performance of the business should improve.
Right. So major earnings are from the steering division, you say?
Yes. Yeah, that's right. Yes.
Okay. Now, is it sustainable?
I mean, as I think the same question has been asked by 3-4 people. If in medium and heavy commercial, farm tractor and passenger continue to grow at this rate, it is sustainable.
Right. Thanks very much, sir. And all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Gaurav Khanna from Stallion Assets. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. So,
we're
trying to understand about the debt
reduction
plan.
We're not able to hear you. Can you speak up,
please?
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
Yeah. So, I just wanted to understand about the debt reduction plan going forward for the group as a whole.
So, as a group as a whole, there is no debt reduction plan. As we mentioned last year, Rane Madras, the debt to capital employed had become a little high, almost reached about 60-62%. So we did that issue to Rane Holdings, and the first tranche was 65 crores was invested, and that was used to repay debt. So debt to capital employed has come down to about 50% now in Rane Madras, and hopefully the same performance continues. Maybe it will be sub 50 by March also. So that makes it quite comfortable. Going forward, there is no significant debt reduction plan per se because all the other companies are well within 35-40% debt to capital employed.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next, we have Anirudh Agarwal from AAA Investment.
Yeah, hi. Thanks for the opportunity. My first question was actually, can you give me the split between steering and diecast revenues in Rane Madras?
Yeah. Just 1 minute.
Yeah.
There in the presentation, right?
So steering, for the current quarter, steering is roughly 270 crores and diecast is around 36 crores.
Okay, and what the question was actually because of the margin improvement. So, because my understanding was that the steering EBITDA would be 11% or 11.5% best case, and now our overall margins are 12.1%. So, is a lot of this contribution coming from the diecast division?
Also, EBITDA level, yes.
Steering has improved the EBITDA level this quarter, as mentioned earlier, with the favorable product mix and good growth compared to the normal EBITDA level, slightly more this quarter it has performed.
Okay, so like, let me ask the margin question in a different way. So with the similar kind of fixed cost structure, what kind of revenues do you think we can reach?
No, let me answer in a slightly different way. Going back to your earlier question, the inherent EBITDA margin of die casting business is higher than steering. But steering, because of a good market condition and a favorable mix, has also improved on the margin.
Right. So steering EBITDA would have improved now, but let's say the other expenses didn't really go up even though revenues grew by 30%. So let's say we had an internal target of 27% revenue CAGR as at FY16 end. So if we continue to grow at 20-25%, what kind of cost movements will we see?
So as Ganesh also mentioned, already there are some concerns on material cost, commodity price increases, etc. So, I mean, if the market conditions continue, maintaining these kind of margins is a possibility.
Right. And in the die casting division, what would be our current capacity utilization?
About 60-odd percent.
Okay, so how do we see this going forward over the next couple of years?
So the, obviously the management is working very hard to fill up the capacity. We had invested based on certain assumption and a certain order book. I think we have explained in the past there were some changes to that because of market condition, etc. So the management team is working on, you know, securing new orders.
Right. And one broad question. So, I mean, we have a land parcel at Virachari. So, why have we not sold that off and used that to repay the debt? I mean, we could sell it at a slight discount to market and, you know, repay a substantial portion of our debt.
Well, as you know, a few years ago we were thinking of selling, but then we decided to put it off the market. The reason is that we don't need that kind of thing with the current performance and the equity infusion. The debt to capital employed in RML has come down, as I said, to below 50%. And if the same performance continues, it will probably be around that 50% or slightly lower. So that is quite sustainable, that debt to capital employed. And therefore, we thought we will use that surplus land sale sometime in the future, not immediately, not required. So we continue to have the head office and R&D of Rane Madras in that location. So we have no immediate plans to liquidate that land.
Right. And what would be the value of that land in your estimate?
No, we have not done a recent estimate.
We haven't done an estimation recently.
Okay, because earlier I think we had said about 150, 160 crores, so that's why I just wanted
to... That was about 2-3 years ago, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, and final question, what do you think are the sustainable asset turns in the steering business?
About 3.5 to 4 in that range, depending on capex cycles, etc.
Okay, and on the die casting side?
Die casting would be only about 1.2, 1.3.
Okay. Thanks a lot. I'll come back in the queue.
Thank you. Next question is from Sunil Kotari from Unique Investment Consultancy. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Congratulations, sir, for very good improvement in at the group level and particularly Rane Madras. Sir, my question is related to diecast. I think what we just now informed is quarterly revenue run rate is what, 35-36 crore?
Yes.
Okay. So, sir, we have, it seems that we have started supplying diecast products to two-wheeler industry, domestic two-wheeler. So, will you say something on what the scope and how you want to grow that business? Because our presence was very negligible.
Right. No, it is a very negligible number, Sunil. In fact, this presentation will be getting updated in the website also. There was a mix-up in the thing. So, there is no major two-wheeler order for diecast. There was one spot order that the business got and we did the spot order, that's all.
Okay, but it is not a very, focused segment for us to grow the diecasting business.
No. So in fact, we will be updating the presentation.
Right. And sir, just now we, on 29 January, we inaugurated this new rack and pinion facility at Varanasi. So what type of investment we made and this related for this has to do with what, some exports potential, or we feel there is domestic demand enough, that's why this new facility?
No, see, the Varanasi plant was the plant which we started when we started winding down Velachery, as you know, and right, shifted most of the production there. About a year and a half ago, we decided to de-risk our rack and pinion production, since we are becoming bigger supplier to Maruti. Just to de-risk our Pondicherry plant, we decided to make rack and pinion steering in Varanasi also. So we started adding rack and pinion capacity there. And there we have set up few lines, and that is the kind of thing that we inaugurated. We had set up one line for a Maruti new model and we got it inaugurated. So already that plant is in operation for the last few years. Rack and pinion is growing very rapidly there because in Pondicherry we have reached a particular capacity and all the expansion of that product we are doing it in Varanasi.
Right, right. And sir, looking at Maruti's expansion plan at Gujarat facility, will it require we have to prepone our investment plan at Gujarat, because just now I think we are supplying from our other facilities. Will it require investment for Rane Madras to make at Sanand or anywhere in Gujarat?
See, Rane Madras, we have a very small facility in Sanand already, right. And we are making now rack and pinion gear, two plants, both Pondicherry and Varanasi. So our intention is to start with, we will use the small facility just for assembly, testing and supply, and watch as we go along, because we need to see which models ultimately Suzuki will make in Gujarat, which models they'll Maruti will make in Manesar and Gurgaon. So as we go along, it also depends on the models that Rane Madras wins. So we are watching. Currently, for the next couple of years, we have enough infrastructure to do assembly, testing, storage, etc. So we are not thinking of expanding Rane Madras in any big way. Rane MSK, we would probably need a facility there. We are considering probably setting up a facility. Currently, we are having a warehouse. We are thinking of a facility in Gujarat.
Great. And, sir, last question is, Rane Madras growing at 25-30%. So do we suppose this market, as you are also just trying to hope for, and we are also wishing that the market grows like this, do we have enough capacity for next 2 years, or will we require some major investment for Rane Madras?
Seeing the robust demand situation for some of our product lines and new applications and new products, we have already, this year, CapEx has been almost fully utilized. So some debottlenecking, some additional lines, the one you talked about, 29 January, those things have been done during this year. Next year, CapEx, we are just in the process of working out the whole next year plan. So it will not be any major new investment, new location, etc., but it will be maybe adding a line here or there, some debottlenecking in some existing plants. So we will probably look at some CapEx as you go forward for 18-19.
All right, sir. Thanks a lot. And just last one request is, sir, if possible, if you can provide a customer-wise sales, I mean, in terms of, say, percentage, whenever, I mean, you feel comfortable by this presentation. Please. Thank you very much.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Pritesh Chadda from Lucky Investment Managers. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir, just one clarification. Rane Madras sells manual steering components and Rane TRW sells manual steering. Is that the way, or how does it differentiate between what is sold in Rane Madras and what is sold in Rane TRW?
So Rane Madras sells manual or mechanical steering gear as a whole and some components of it. Rane TRW makes the hydraulic rack and pinion steering and hydraulic fully integrated steering for mechanical, for medium and heavy commercial vehicles. And Rane NSK makes electric steering for passenger cars.
Yes. So Rane TRW makes it for CVs. And where does the application for the manual steering in case of Rane Madras goes in?
To all the cars like Maruti, Renault, Tata Motors, all passenger car applications.
Manual steering?
Manual, see, the electric power steering in India, by and large, is what we call an electric column-driven power steering. So wherever there is an electric column steering, there is a mechanical rack and pinion. So the electric column is supplied by Rane NSK, and the mechanical rack and pinion is supplied by Rane Madras.
Okay.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Arvind Joshi from Battleya Advisors. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, sir. Sir, are the plans of hitting certain targets on return on capital employed, I'm talking about Rane Madras, were adversely affected due to headwinds in the last 3-4 years. Now, seeing the change scenario and very favorable product mix and good demand from our user industries, do you think next year we could be on target to hit our 25% plus return ratios for Rane Madras, or probably exceed them?
So, you know, I think we've explained in the past, definitely there is possibility of exceeding 20%, and that is the target for the total business. Now, if all the stars are aligned.
Except the U.S. business. I think we should be on a pretty good clip, excepting the U.S. business. I think we should be able to hit very nice figures.
Well, yeah, except that the die casting business also is undergoing capacity underutilization right now, so we have to fill that up. So, So and on a sustainable basis, 20% plus is the target, and we think is more realistic. Now, like the last quarter, we could have a very good performance and where the numbers go up even further, but on a sustainable basis.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Purvi Banka from Prabhudas Lilladher. Please go ahead. Ms. Purvi Banka from Prabhudas Lilladher, you may go ahead with your question. There seems to be no response from the line of Purvi Banka. We move to the next question. The next question is from the line of Viraj V from Securities Investment Management. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Thanks for the opportunity again. I just had two questions on Rane LSK. Now, if you look at the space in passenger vehicle space in last 3 to 4 years, we've seen increased competition from new players. You know, we have seen Mando Corporation, which has primarily been a supplier to Hyundai, also catering now like for other OE businesses. Similar to the case from ZF. So how are we looking at this, and how do we intend to maintain and grow profitably? So if you can just provide some color on that.
Well, I think, competition in a growing market like India is a reality. And as you rightly said, Mando is a serious player and competition. So, we have to constantly improve our performance and try to maintain market share, try to win enough models to keep our growth, and also look at international markets. We also have to increase our presence in the international market. And as you know, that is one of our strategies. So we cannot entirely depend only on the existing domestic market. So both ways, we have to make sure that despite competition, we also have a healthy growth rate.
So coming to being on a new platform, so say for Maruti, would we be catering to the new Swift, which is being launched, and also the new upcoming Ertiga, which they're planning to launch in FY19.
Yeah, we'll be getting into some of the new models. We keep getting new model businesses as we go along. So very specific models, for obvious reasons, we would not like to share, but definitely we are, constantly working for refreshing and being in the new models. That is the way we can keep our growth going.
And if you can just provide a bit more color on export side, where are we seeing the growth opportunity? Will it be primarily through NSK? Will come primarily from NSK looking to use India as a base for some of its business? Or, how are we approaching the export opportunity?
No, yeah. The answer is actually the main growth for exports is coming from this particular quarter or last couple of quarters is driven by Rane TRW, but overall the growth is coming from Rane TRW, Rane Madras, and Rane Engine Valves. Those would be the primary businesses for the export business.
Okay.
Rane NSK and Rane Brake Lining is at a much, much lower level.
So my question was primarily on Rane NSK, as I mentioned about...
Okay. The joint venture, of course, time to time explores opportunities for export, but the focus is on the domestic market.
Okay. Okay, fine. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ravi Purohit from Securities Investment Private Limited.
Hi, thanks for taking my questions. So I have two questions. One is, we have this understanding or JV with Nishimbo on our brake lining business, and Nishimbo had acquired this TMD in Europe, and couple of quarters back, or maybe about a year back, we had mentioned about some opportunities in the aftermarket in Europe. Any progress there, if you could update us?
Actually, they're moving very slowly. While some work is going on, we have given some samples, some prototypes, etc. To be honest, that is going very, very slow. We continue to work on it, not that we have stopped, but it's not going at the pace at which we would like it to. So in the near horizon, we don't see much happening there, but we continue to work through TMD to increase our exports to Europe.
Okay. And sir, we had also mentioned a couple of quarters back about our interest in creating or, you know, kind of getting a JV in the aerospace. Any progress that you can share with the shareholders?
Nothing much. We continue to work and we have seen few proposals coming our way. We've gone around and seen a few, but nothing so far to really share with you at this stage. Yeah, we continue to look for some opportunities in that area.
Okay. And so last question is on this telematics acquisition, which we made a couple of quarters back again. Any updates or any additional insight that you could share with us, you know, having acquired that company for...
There's nothing to update. It's a very small piece of the business. You know, the revenue is small, but it's more from a long-term perspective. We believe there is potential. Of course, it's also a new area for us, so we're still trying to understand the business, assess the opportunities, etc. Of course, we still believe there is a good opportunity.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for your...
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Ashutosh Garud from Reliance Portfolio Management.
Hello.
Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, can you let us know the total capacity you have in Rane Madras?
It's very difficult because different products, but all I can tell you is the steering side, we are operating at a very high capacity utilization now, close to 90%. And therefore, as I said earlier, we have added some capacity, we have debottlenecked and stretched our capacity here and there. So steering is working at almost full capacity now.
So this addition debottlenecking which has taken place, so how, what percentage growth in volumes can you see at least on the how much more utilization can we pull out of this?
No, currently we are just about managing with about 90% utilization. Once our next year plans, sales plan, etc. is frozen, which we normally do by March, then automatically the capex required for 18-19 will work out. So at this stage, that homework is going on now.
Okay. So the kind of top line which we saw of around 320 crore kind of a top line, that would be generally the run rate because the utilization levels are at peak basically.
I'm going back to the same answer. If M&HCV, passenger car and farm tractor grow at the same rate, yes.
So this kind of, even though there is an incremental demand because of our utilization levels are at peak, we may not be able to increase this kind of top line to by let's say 20-25% going ahead.
Yes, so we will add capacity.
As I said, we are already in the process. This year, capex, we are almost fully spending. And wherever required, we have added capacity. We have added a lot of materials bought out also in Rane Madras. So we have upgraded our vendor capacity, added sources where required. So it is the whole ecosystem.
So let's say once you start spending an X amount, how much time does it take for the incremental capacity to get transferred?
It depends on the bottleneck in a particular product for a farm tractor or a passenger car. It could be anywhere from 1 month to 6 months, depending on the kind of bottleneck.
Okay. And in case of a brownfield expansion?
Brownfield typically will take 6 months, 6 to 7 months.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Sunil Kothari from Unique Investment Consultancy. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much, sir. Sir, again, on this aftermarket sales, which is really growing well in Rane Madras, we reach almost 50 crore per quarter. So how do you see those segments? Because since long we are trying to capture a good share of aftermarket sales. Can you throw some light on the opportunity and scope?
Actually, aftermarket on a YTD basis, the growth has been only muted because the first two quarters were not good. So third quarter, there's been some catching up. And we are optimistic that, the market is slowly settling down and the growth should continue.
So So opportunity seems to be bigger than what we achieved, or how you see this opportunity aftermarket market?
Sorry?
The opportunity in this aftermarket sales is bigger than what we achieved, or how you see those opportunities?
No, so honestly, we feel that this quarter there was a lot of pent-up demand that we caught up on because of GST impact, etc. On a sustainable basis, this market grows at about 10%.
Okay. And we have those network and ability to cater the market.
Yes. Yeah. So, I mean, the RML is well positioned, and we continue to add distributors, etc. So, that's an ongoing process.
Okay. And, Harish, related to this previous person's question, if there is a demand, can we supply, say, worth 375 crore, 400 crore next year, 18-19, any quarterly run rate? If there is a demand, we have enough ability to supply those much of products worth revenue?
No, I mean, it's not readily available, but we can also gradually ramp up. So,
Okay. So, we have yet to prepare ourselves for a bigger demand.
No, we are in the process. I mean, as Mr. Ganesh said, we had a capex that we had budgeted, assuming a certain growth rate, and we said if that happens, we'll spend the money. So that is happening. And for next year, the teams are working. So, and wherever certain bottlenecks in advance need to be addressed, they're getting addressed.
Thank you very much, sir. Wish you good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next, we have a follow-up question from the line of Anirudh Agarwal from AAA Investment.
Yeah, thanks again. So, on Rane Madras, who are our key competitors on both steering and die-casting?
Steering, for Rane Madras, you're asking?
Yeah, Rane Madras.
So steering is what used to be Sona, now is JTEC. They would be the main competitor. Of course, Mando is also there. And QH for the linkages. As far as die casting is concerned, you know, it's very difficult to name one competitor because the industry is so large and there are so many players. So there are lots of companies.
Right. So what has the competitive intensity been like over the past few quarters? Hello.
Participants, please stay connected. We seem to have lost the line for the management. Please stay connected while we call them back. Participants, thank you for patiently waiting. We have the management reconnected.
Hello. Yeah. So, what has the competitive intensity been like over the past few quarters?
I mean, nothing has changed. The competition intensity continues to be high. So, wherever, you know, what happens in current quarters are businesses that were won or sourced 2-3 years ago. And we are right now in this quarter bidding for businesses in 2019, etc. So the intensity continues to be the same as ever.
So I mean, bidding for businesses in 2019, then do we see this kind of performance going forward? I mean, that would give us some indication, right?
Yeah, I mean, assuming, so every customer gives a 2019 based on a certain growth rate. If that happens, yes.
Right. And so what is the key risk factor, the key challenge that we see in Rane Madras specifically?
I mean, it's mainly the market. You know, if the market, if there is any sudden slowdown in the market, you know, this commercial vehicle is always a difficult one to guess because we know that commercial vehicle is a cyclical industry. So we know for a fact that after every few years, there is a few negative quarters and then flat quarters and again positive quarters. So the key question is, when will this negative start? And the same with farm tractor. You know, farm tractor has had two consecutive years of excellent growth. Now, generally, if you go back the last 20 years, it tends to be cyclical. But of course, now the latest view is with all the budget that's been done for the agricultural sector, farm will continue. But, you know, we never know if these things are right or wrong. So if any of these things, you know, turn around, either M&SCV or tractor, then that can impact. And of course, the other risk factors, we are all working towards improving the capacity utilization of die casting. So that also needs to happen.
Right. And specifically then on the U.S. die casting, I think U.S. passenger vehicle market seems to have sort of topped out and, you know, now gradually degrowing. So then in such a scenario, how do we grow the business there?
So, you know, there the business is not so much about growth. You know, that business, we never can imagine it will grow like in India, you know, 15, 20, 22%, etc. That business plan had planned only for about a 4% growth year on year. So the challenge there is to, you know, make it profitable. So that's the main challenge.
Right. And also on the, specifically on the India die casting business, I mean, what would be our target ROC in that division?
I mean, from a short-term perspective, it's about 18%.
18. Okay, so then the EBITDA would be very high, right? I mean, otherwise, if asset turns only 1.2, 1.3, EBITDA would have to be very high for ROC of 18%.
Correct.
So what, I mean, is it 20% plus or how do we see it?
In that range.
In that range.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks a lot.
18-19% is the target.
18-19. And currently we are at?
In about 14.
So how much time, in how much time do we think we can get to 18-19?
No, it depends on, you know, how much orders we secure in the coming quarters.
Right. How does the pipeline look for those orders?
I mean, we still believe there are a lot of opportunities, but it's, you know, we cannot comment on it till we actually secure a contract.
Right.
Also, the startup and ramp up in diecast is slightly longer. It takes a while, time making, proving, and, you know, sampling, etc. So from a new order to start of commercial takes slightly longer in diecasting than a, let's say, a typical steering product.
Right. And I also think we had mentioned that we were working on a couple of major export orders in Rane Madras. So, like, by when do you think, like, indicatively, can we see some movement on those orders?
Yeah, there's nothing big. I mean, orders, you know, regular, it's a part of regular business acquisition. Orders happen. The one that happened, like, next year, that was a very massive one, and unfortunately, we have also not clear on the future direction, but there's nothing else significant like that.
Okay. And in margins on those orders would be higher than our domestic margins. Is that a correct way to understand?
Yes. I mean, again, with the assumption on the current forex rates. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks a lot. That's it from my side.
The forex is another risk which you were talking about. We are currently trying to grapple with what's going to happen to the rupee dollar, that because of our export exposure. That could be another risk that we are facing.
Thank you. We take the next question from the line of Umesh Gupta from Reliance Wealth. Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, for Rane Madras, could you quantify the GST benefit?
It's difficult to quantify. But in our, auto industry, basically being B2B, whatever there is a benefit is exactly passed on to the customer. So there is no question of really benefiting from GST. It's a very complex question to answer.
No, so the margins which you have reported, you mean to say there has been no benefit and these are like normal operative margins?
That's right. That's right.
Okay. So what has been the reason for improvement in margins both on Q1Q and YOY basis? The main factors.
Is it capacity utilization, volume, good product mix. You know, aftermarket is more profitable. Aftermarket has done very well. So that plus the capacity utilization and some interest reduction also due to equity infusion. The combination of these three or four factors, I think.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. That was the last question. I would now like to hand the conference back to the management for closing comments.
So, thank you very much for joining. I hope we answered most of your questions to your satisfaction and look forward to a good year in 18-19. Thank you.
Thank you very much.